Hi, you're on Problem Spot, and this is DevScoOPS, a rapid show and tell on the use of DevOps tools in at most 3 minutes. So if this tickles your fancy, click the subscribe button. So let's get into it. Compressed files can be created from Docker images, which means these files can be stored in an S3 bucket. This is not usually something that is done in actual practice, but in case you find a use case, let's go and have a look at how Docker images can be stored in an S3 bucket. So I have my Docker image on this repository, which I created as part of a series on building an event-driven application, which you can access right here. I'll be using the Docker configuration file for my backend service. Before I start building my Docker image, let me make sure that I start cleanly and purge my unused Docker images on my system. So I'm going to open my terminal on my VS Code, and I'm going to prune all my Docker resources on my system. And now I'm going to start building my Docker image. So I'll cd to the application directory and then run this command. The build is done, so let me check the image that was created. What I need to do next is save my Docker image into a compressed file. And if I list the backend tar file in here, so now I have a compressed file representation of my Docker image. I'm going to go ahead and upload this file to my S3 bucket. So now that I have this tar file saved to my S3 bucket, I'm going to start a container using the Docker image that I built. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open my Docker Compose file, and then I'm going to get rid of the worker block to make sure that I only start the backend service. And then I'm going to update my backend service to point to the image that's sitting on my local machine. So now let me open my terminal again and then start Docker Compose. And now I'm going to switch to my browser and verify if the application is loading fine. And yeah, that looks good. And now let me switch back to my VS Code and then stop this Docker Compose. And then I'm going to remove all containers that are running as part of this Docker Compose. And then I'm going to prune all my Docker resources on my machine just to make sure that I don't have any lingering images. And now I'm going to check my Docker images, and nothing is there at the moment. So if I go ahead and download the Docker image from my S3 bucket, so I've successfully downloaded my backend.tar file from my S3 bucket. So if I ls in here, then what I need to do next is load my Docker image using this tar file by running a docker load command. And now if I run Docker images, I have a new image in there, which points to the same repository and tag that I've created previously. Because it is using the same image name and tag, I'm just going to try starting the application using my current Docker Compose setup. Let me switch to my browser and check my application. And it still works. And that's my 3 minutes. Until next time, see ya.